In this tutorial, you learn the tasks typically performed by Enterprise Journals administrators. Enabling Enterprise Journals in the application, identifying targets and creating connections, configuring journal periods, creating journal templates, creating recurring journals, deploying Enterprise Journals templates to an open journal period, and monitoring the progress of journals using dashboards. You are signed in as an Enterprise Journals administrator. You can enable the Enterprise Journals feature during the application creation process. If you need to enable Enterprise Journals after the application creation process, enable it here. In order to post journals to Oracle Cloud General Ledger, you must create a connection to the target ERP system. Select Other Web Service Provider. Enter the connection details using your preferred cloud administrator user, and then save and close the connection. The connection is visible in the list. Administrators access Enterprise Journals administrative tasks via the Enterprise Journals link under Application in the Navigator. The Dimensions page lists all available system dimensions and local dimensions. You use dimensions to guide user data entry in the journals. You can add your own local dimensions and then add and edit dimension attributes and members. For each local dimension, the system retains a history of the changes. Create targets that contain the definition and properties of the target ERP system where you want to post journals. Specify a unique identifier for the target ID. Enter the target name, an optional description, and select the target type. The system provides a seeded target type named Cloud Financials. If you select the Cloud Financials target type, the Direct Integration checkbox is checked by default. Direct integration is a dedicated posting process to the ERP system. The connections list is only displayed if direct integration is enabled. Select the connection from the list. Posting options are only displayed if direct integration is enabled. You can select to enable or disable automatic posting by the system. Note, disabling posting is predominantly used in testing scenarios where the Cloud Financials ERP is not available and you would like to turn off post actions while continuing the workflow levels. In this case, the journals would continue to qualify for ready-to-post status, and once the ERP is ready, you could enable posting. Attributes for each target are specified according to the general ledger posting requirements for your business. Enterprise Journals provides the default seeded attributes for Cloud Financials direct posting. If you are not using Cloud Financials, attributes can be added according to your requirements. You can import and export attributes in bulk if needed. For each target, the system retains a history of the changes made to it. For example, changes in properties or attributes. Save your changes. Before you can work with journals, you must define the journal period, including the year, start, end, and close dates. When you deploy a journal template, you can deploy it to a pending or open journal period. The journal template defines the journal layout that preparers use when working on their ad hoc or recurring journals. Each journal created in Enterprise Journals is connected to a journal template. You can create as many journal templates as needed. Typically, a single journal template is used for all journals that have a common target and other common posting requirements. On the Properties tab, enter a name, description, and target. Select Ad Hoc Journals if you want users to be able to create additional journals for the period other than the recurring journals defined in the template, or to create journals from other EPM processes, such as account reconciliation. Specify the users or roles that can create ad hoc journals. Provide instructions for users on what this journal template is for. Instructions can include text, attached files, and links to files in document repositories. A template includes predefined sections for the header and line item details. The journal header stores the attributes for the header section of the journal. Journal name and journal ID are required attributes. Journal name is a text attribute. Journal ID is unique to a journal for each year and period. It can be auto-generated or user input. Optionally, you can assign a prefix or suffix. You can add columns to accommodate a large number of attributes. The maximum is 3 columns. Select the attributes to be included for display. All attributes are shared across all templates, so you must select the attributes to be included for display. Select whether an attribute is view only. You can add attributes as needed. The History tab displays changes to the template sections, including the user who modified it, the date, the type of modification, and old and new values. For the Line Items Detail section, use the Group By tab to specify how to group attribute columns. Use the Mapping tab to link each target attribute to the appropriate journal attribute for this template. Both header and line item template attributes are mapped within this tab. Use the Journals tab to specify the journal workflow parameters, including the start and end dates, workflow options, and recurring journals. You can create questions for journal users, specify the data type, the roles, and whether the questions are required. Use the Access tab to determine which users have view access to journals, whether they have view access to ad hoc journals, and their level of access. The History tab is an audit of the changes made to the template. Save your changes. You can edit, duplicate, and delete templates, and add and reorder columns. After you create a template, you can deploy it to a pending or open journal period. Deploying a template creates the recurring journals associated with the template for the selected period. It also allows you to create ad hoc journals using the deploy template. You can redeploy a previously deployed template. You can also undeploy a journal template, which permanently deletes all the existing data and unposted journals for the period. Journals that are already posted cannot be deleted. Once you deploy a template, preparers can begin the process of creating ad hoc journals or editing recurring journals. Use the Enterprise Journals Overview dashboard to display journal status. For a selected point of view, you can view at a glance a count of open, late, or on-time journals and the completion status for selected journals. You can filter the list by journal templates, workflow status, posting status or target, and sort the list by alphabetical or count. Drill down to view journal details. The Compliance dashboard enables you to view at a glance the journals that were prepared, reviewed, posted, and completed on time, those that were late, and those that were rejected. You can filter the list of journals by performance and change the order of the list. All users can access the Enterprise Journals list via the Enterprise Journals card on the homepage. The Journals list provides a central place to manage all journals. Administrators can see all the available journals in the system, while users can see all the journals assigned to them. Check the description for links to related videos. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.